This is Thisa Villa's Family Farms, and I've been intending to film this the whole time, but I forgot to. But Kenzie and I are doing some baking and stuff and getting ready for tomorrow, because we're going to my parents tomorrow for Christmas on Friday. And so let me show you what she's doing. Here's my pie crust, and it'll taste fine, I'm sure. But it's a homemade pie crust. And here's Kenzie. She's putting together the pecans. You know what? How much did you put in there? A cup?
I'm going to put a cup in a bowl.
Okay. Add some more.
Okay.
We like lots of pecans in our pecan pie. But you have everything else in it now?
Like everything.
Whatever. Actually, stop there and I'll show you what to do after that. Mix that all up and we'll put it in the pie crust, and then we'll do something else. This is Candy, who keeps hoping we will drop something. I don't know if you heard that or not. Kenzie had dropped a pecan, and so Candy waited for it quickly and ate it up for her. So we got the pecan pie going, and I've got deviled eggs. Kenzie shelled the eggs for me, and so we've got deviled eggs started, and then we're going to do a couple other things to take with us tomorrow. And Kenzie's excited because her brother gets to go with us tomorrow. We really like a lot of pecans in our pie, and she's got a pretty good amount in here so far, but I'm going to show you what I do. Grab another handful, throw that in there, without throwing it on the ground.
I'm going to drop like a half.
Okay, now, put your bag down and grab your spatula and kind of dunk them. You want me to show you?
Yeah, kind of.
We want all the pecans to have gunk on them. So we make sure they're all dunked. Oh yeah, this is going to be a good pecan pie. We may have to make a second one just so we can have one for ourselves. I don't know, but we'll get that. All right.
Okay, Grandma is now going to put it in the oven.
I'm going to put some sort of pan underneath it in case it leaks or something, but it's not that full, so we should be okay there. All right, how long does it say to cook it for?
Okay, I am now mixing up, mushing up the egg yolks to make the deviled eggs scented, and Candy is closely watching me. She really wants some, don't you, Candy? You can't eat the camera though, it's not an egg. Bye.
All right, Kenzie has already taken a fork and crunched up all the eggs for us, and now go ahead and take your spoon and dump all of that in there. Most people like sweet relish, but I'm not crazy about sweet relish at all, so we're doing dill relish. And I like a fair amount in it, and that looks like a pretty good amount. Once you mix it in, it doesn't look quite nearly as much. Now I'll put just a small squeeze of mustard in it. Doesn't take very much at all. If you put too much, you go, oh my gosh, I've got too much mustard. Yeah. Oh, now see how smart she is? She's shaking the mustard so you don't get that nasty mustard water in the beginning. How smart. A little bit more. There you go. That's plenty. Now squeeze in some ranch.
How much?
Pretty good amount. I mean, we're not blopping it, but we're...
Somebody want to stop.
Okay. Let it run down. I'm going to have to wait and get some. Let me go get some more. We had run out, and we are kind of running out now, but here's how much she put in it. So that looks pretty good. And now for the mayonnaise or Miracle Whip, whatever it is that we got this time. And what I would do with you, since that's so close to the bottom, I would just take the bully legs completely off. All right. We don't know how much, if that's enough mayonnaise, but she's going to stir that up and we're going to check the consistency of it. And as she licks parts of it off her hand. Okay. I didn't realize I needed it. That's pretty creamy though, isn't it? We'll check it out here in a minute.
Okay.
Wait. Kenzie wants a fancy one because she's learning how to do this, so she's going to show us how to put this little thing together.
So what you have to do is you have to basically take whatever little chip you want. You have to put it in the little twist on thing, and then you just screw it on.
Okay. And then what?
And then what we do, we fold it over like this so that it looks sliders it.
Makes it easier to get it down there.
But I guess because if you get on the side, it's still in the bag.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, now we're just going to try this.
Is it pretty good mixed up? You want me to hold that part for you?
Please.
I'm on the wrong side?
That's fine.
So what's the technique you're going to use?
I don't know.
Are you going to swirl it or are you going to do?
I might just like do like push, just do like a little up and down.
Okay, so we're going to watch you.
I might be blue.
You want to do it over here, by the on the table?
Oh, yeah. I know, it's over there. So what we're going to do, well, we might as well spoil it. Maybe.
Hand
up the top.
Is it? You want me to take over?
Grandma's going to take this over, and we're just going to do like a little spoil.
Okay, it wasn't mixed up quite as good as we thought.
But it's still mixed.
Oh, you know what the deal was? It wasn't. That wasn't a problem. It was the.
This. It would.
Let's try it this way. It was the relish.
I knew what the pipe bomb did.
We have stuff coming out the top.
Then Grandma had to eat it.
Can't let it go to waste.
I could have ate it. How about if we have extra? Do we eat it?
I don't know. Let's see. There shouldn't be too much extra.
That one's a small one.
Mm-hmm. You straighten that one up?
Sorry. I got distracted by the little thing that fell out. Fourth row completed. Oh, what? You have a little extra? You have a lot of extra.
Okay, which one looks a little bit low? This one's not quite filled up.
No.
Yeah, there's not much left over.
This one's like that. That one. That one. That one missed.
Alright, I think that's it.
Okay, now what?
I guess put the lid on and put in the fridge and we have to save it tomorrow, and I guess whatever little extra stuff you can get out of it. The blue light's on the side. This might be the last time we use this bag.